Guys, in this video, I'm going to go over a problem. This was one of my questions that I had in a quiz in a Calc 3 class, and it says to find the volume of a parallelepiped with adjacent edges PQ, PR, PS, and we're given the coordinates of PQ, R, and S. So here's a sample image of what a parallelepiped is. It's basically a three-dimensional shape made up of parallelograms. So if we call this vertex P, for example, we can have this be Q, this here can be R, and this S, so we have PQ, PR, PS. Then the way to find a parallelepiped with this type of problem is to write out the lines PQ, PR, and PS as displacement vectors. And so you can write the components of the displacement vectors for the three lines. And the volume, which we're asked to find, is the absolute value of this triple product. So if we consider PQ to be A, PR to be B, and PS to be C, then the triple product of either A, B, C will be the solution to the problem. And I'm not going to prove it in this video, but the absolute value of this scalar triple product is equivalent to finding the determinant of the three components of the three line vectors. So A is going to be made up of A1, A2, A3, and so on and so forth for these. And so the volume will equal to the scalar triple product, which is equal to finding the determinant of A1, A2, A3, B1, B2, B3, and C1, C2, C3. So those are the steps, and so let's go ahead and solve it for this particular problem. So we're given the coordinates, so I'm going to do the second letter minus P for all of them. So for PQ, it's going to be negative 1 minus 3, that's going to be negative 4. 2 minus 0 is going to be 2. 5 minus 1 is going to be 4. For PR, it's going to be 5 minus 3, which is 2. 1 minus 0, which is 1. Negative 1 minus 1, which is negative 2. And then for PS, it's going to be 0 minus 3, which is negative 3. 4 minus 0, which is 4. And 2 minus 1, which is 1. So we have the A, B, and C vectors. And now we can write the components in a 3x3 matrix and find the determinant. So that's going to be negative 4, 2, 4, 2, 1, negative 2, negative 3, 4, 1. Looking at the matrix, we're going to take out negative 4 and then ignore the rest of the first row and first column. And then it's going to be 1 times 1, which is 1, minus 4 times negative 2, which is negative 8. So we're going to have plus 8. Minus the second value of the first row, so that's 2. Then we ignore the first row and the second column, so we have 2 times 1 is 2, minus negative 3 times negative 2, which is 6, plus the fourth value, which is a 4. We ignore the first row and the third column, and then we do 2 times 4, which is 8, plus 3, so minus negative 3. So that's going to give us negative 36 plus 8 plus 4 times 11, which is 44. And if you add all those values together, we're going to get 16 as the final answer. So the volume of this particular parallelepiped is 16, and we're done with this problem.